FM source for news. KRDO News Radio, 105.5 FM and 1240 AM.
Yeah. I get a feeling that I never, 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 never had before. No, no. Yeah. I just want to tell you right now that,
Richard Serrett, call the wildcard line at 818-501-4109. The first-time caller line is 818-501-4721. To talk to Richard from east of the Rockies, call 800-825-5033. From west of the Rockies, toll-free, call 800-618-8255. International callers may reach Richard by calling their in-country Sprint access number, pressing option 5, and dialing toll-free, 800-893-0903. This is Coast to Coast AM with your guest host, Richard Serrett.
There she is, the matriarch of R&B, Miss Peaches, as she was known. We are trending the hashtag Richard C2C. Richard, C as in Coast, 2, the number 2, and C as in Coast. Hashtag Richard C2C. All right, back to open lines and the website, richardserrett.com, and you can say hello on Twitter at Richard Serrett. Before I get back to the calls, I just want to throw another log on the fire here. And yet, here I had
Mad Martian, Gary, that's his real name, Gary Legere.
And in the meantime, we'll go once again to the wild card line and in Fountain, Colorado. Is it Clatu?
Yes, it is. How you doing, Rich?
I'm well, Clatu. Good morning.
All right. Thanks, Daniel, for letting me on. Am I coming up close? All right, before we go on.
I'm sorry, I didn't catch that.
Can you hear me okay?
I can hear you loud and clear.
Oh, all right. Great. But again, you know, you got invited at the beginning of the show, open lines and that, you know, someone could call in and basically steer the ship. Well, is that still open? Because have I got a ride for you all?
All right. Take us.
All right. And, you know, it was great tonight, too. And, you know, Mr. Hoagland was on. And he's kind of involved with this. But it's very interesting. He was right. Whether you know it or not, Richard, you're spot on. You're spot on this code talk. What am I talking about? What is Hoagland talking about? What is this code talk he's talking about? Let's go to Brookings. I know it might take a little time, but I want to break it down from what I see and where we're at and this disclosure that's coming forth to which no one could talk about. Goes back to Brookings. Under what circumstances will we be presented or withheld? Think of it as a riddle. Under what circumstances will we be presented or withheld data and or disclosure, information of disclosure? Now, what if that became policy? And he said this to me on my show years ago. But what if that became policy? And to which total suppression, as he said in the past and also on your show and possibly with you even, forgive my ignorance there. And, you know, I like you, by the way. You know, I like you. You're spot on with a lot of the things. That's why he's right of what you said. It's like you're following along easily. And how I see this code speak and what he's really alluding to of our model of the solar system, we have a solar system model, a mathematical problem, an artifact, an alien artifact, with the hint of intelligence being given to us under Brookings, now, mind you, under what circumstances will we be presented or withheld data and or disclosure of what they found out there? Like, you're familiar with the X-Files, correct?
Oh, yes, and it's coming back.
All right. The truth is out there. Indeed. What if it's out there, in fact, in things that we've already seen over the years, or may not have seen, obviously, in this case, but to a lot, many people. But maybe now some, thanks to me and the effort behind it, and Hoagland's kicking my behind in some ways to get me to see it, I believe. But we won't get into that. I want to focus on the model of Brookings, which what he was saying alludes exactly to what I found, and he was right. At the end, when basically someone's saying, hey, it's time. The time to either get it out or someone else is going to do it. Again, that falls back to the hint of Brookings. Under what circumstances will we be presented with data via videos, acclimation? What if all this is an acclimation program leading to which being discussed on the surface is just a surface, a cover, a circle, a cover story that is coded in ways that can connect over years, even if you follow a script, and to which spells out a scenario. If you see that script and you change that script from the surface for the Type 2 civilization in code, which would mean the undersurface, the story undercover. There's two tracks. Second track diplomacy, Hoagland would say. There's two tracks. One track on the surface where it's an official story, as it was, a cover story. But if you have certain knowledge of key points, like I've learned over the years and that he's helped me to see, mind you, it leads us to see a disclosure which brings an unofficial disclosure, especially by individuals pointed out in this, literally.
Let me just jump in, Klaatu, and let me ask you. Let me just cut to the quick here because we've got a break coming up. And let me ask you, what is it going to take? Because you mentioned, you know, this is policy. Well, some might argue that we've had this disclosure policy since Truman, when the whole UFO ET issue, for example, was placed in private hands for, you know, back engineering and development of alien technologies and so forth. So we've had 70 years of this disclosure policy. What's it going to take? Is it going to be the Chinese forcing the U.S.'s hands? What's it going to take for disclosure to happen? Because I don't necessarily think it's ever going to happen. I don't think we even need it to happen at an official level.
Well, this has to come first. According to what I see in this code down through time, I call it, Hoagland leading me, again, behind the surface unofficially. On the surface, he's talking whatever, and he has talked whatever. We'll get into, you know, we won't get into that. What I'm saying is the science and the model of what he said on your show. I'm going to paint that picture, and it's going to prove it. It's going to vindicate his words, to which he will be, how do you say, validated. Vindicated.
Okay, but you've got about 50 seconds. Can you get it done in about 50 seconds?
There's a video called UFO Diaries. Watch that opening line very carefully. It's the model, the solar system scale model, Hoagland's referring to in code. Hoagland in code is NASA. When he says NASA, he's referring to himself. I'm painting it. I'm going to prove it. FacesOfMars.com. I'd really like to be our guest on your show, sir, to talk a couple hours about this because it will blow you and your audiences away. And in fact, it's what Hoagland really wants. So officially on the surface, he won't admit it. But I'm painting the picture, using his own words, leading the way. This is not a coincidence. Again, based on Brookings. He also told me my voice once was going to be at the head of the wave of the straight disclosure, and that my voice was going to be a huge part in it, in this acclimation program. At the time, I thought it was my radio show. No, he said I had a job for him to do. Well, I've been helping him over the years. I think I see what that job is, because on the surface, he can never admit it to me. On the surface, he has to attack me and attack anyone until, like you said, it's time to when it's allowed, to when the officials can possibly acknowledge it.
So your suggestion here, Klaatu, is that Richard C. Hoagland is being used as part of this controlled disclosure. Is that the idea?
But it has affected my life, not just as an audience.
Well, if it's true, it's going to affect all of our lives, isn't it?
Remember what he said, Richard, about a game changer? I'm the game changer to the game that's exposing and showing his code where on the surface it destroys him because of his official ties to these things. No one could admit it, but yet he gave us the data years ago, and he's been giving us the data over the years and everything he's saying. I'm seeing the Hoagland I know behind the surface, and that's the one I'm having faith in.
All right, Klaatu, I appreciate the call. Checking in from Fountain, Colorado. Following the river with the Rolling Stones. Richard Serrett, sitting in for George Nori, Coast to Coast, continues with your calls right after this.
Don't forget to watch our TV show, Beyond Belief, with George Nori. Simply go to beyondbelief.com. The way your comb's tucked in your hair.